Hi, I'm back. After a long break, I am back with a long overdue video. So hi, how you doing?
How are you?
I'm gonna be doing something that I had been putting off for an entire year. Yeah, you heard me correctly, entire year. So in Christmas of 2021, I was bestowed an amazing gift. I got a sewing machine for Christmas, which I was over the freaking moon about. I was so excited. I almost bought one, but my fiance was like, no, don't do it. Like, just don't do it. And I was like, why? What do you know? And he couldn't tell me. But the gag was I had already had one. I just didn't know it because it was wrapped up under the tree. And then I went home and I looked at it. I took it out the box and I just looked at it. And I looked at all the parts that I came with, and it scared the shit out of me, so I proceeded to not touch it for an entire year. I know. Yeah, I deserve that. Yeah. Alright. I got some shit, okay? I learned my lesson. Alright, anyway. Yeah, I didn't touch it for a whole year. If you are a fellow perfectionist such as myself, then you either put too much of your effort into one thing and burn out very easily, or you just won't touch it because you don't think you're gonna be any good at it, and so you just don't even give it a try. That's kind of what happened here. Yeah, I know, it's stupid, but that's what happened. I didn't touch it for a whole year, and what was even worse is that my fiance's parents got it for me, so like every time they like would talk to me, they'd be like, hey, so what have you made? Have you made anything? Have you tried it? And I'm like, no. So they were really sweet though, and they didn't push me any or anything, but them asking me was enough for me to be like, bitch, you better make something with this damn present they gave you. So that brought me to this video today, where I decided to make the one thing that I have been obsessing over for a very long time. I've been being haunted by Rihanna's ghost. I'm serious. I'm not joking. Do you remember the era, the time that Rihanna was going through her phase, and she decided to wear these fat ass, big ass, fluffy ass bucket hats in the dead of summer? Yeah, I do. I think about it randomly at like 3 a.m. in the middle of the night. It wakes me up and I'm just like, I want that damn bucket hat. They were so fucking cute. And I could just hear my inner child from the early 2000s being like, that's hot.
That's hot.
That's so hot and I need it. But I looked it up and them hats cost like $70-$80. So I went online and I looked up fluffy bucket hat. And I came across that Anuli's video where she does a do-it-yourself fluffy bucket hat. I watched it like 50 times before I even picked up or touched my sewing machine. I watched that tutorial. So guess what I did? Bitch, I made it. Do you like it? I love it. It's so freaking cute. This was like the funnest thing I've ever done, or the funnest thing I've done in a long time, I should say. And I can't believe I made this. Like, I made this. One of the other reasons I made a point, like, I finally snapped and was like, I'm gonna make this fucking hat, is because it's my birthday month. It's my birthday month. And I refuse to go into another year of life without having a fluffy bucket hat. I think that's fucking insane. So I made one. My birthday is March 24th, by the way, if you guys were wondering. I know that the summer is about to happen, but guess what? If Queen Rihanna can wear fluffy bucket hats in the dead of summer, I can wear a fluffy bucket hat in spring.
Nigga, why are you hollering?
So, wanna see how I made this and chit chat with me and all that cute stuff? Stay tuned.
All right, so jumping right into it, this is the pattern that I downloaded from Thou Art Anuli's video. This is, I believe, the brim. This is the band. And the next one is the top part of the hat. This pattern was free when she uploaded this video, but it's no longer free. It's $5. I highly suggest you get this pattern because it's big enough and it gives you a really big ass bucket hat. So right here, I folded the fabric that I chose over in half and I followed the instructions, pinned the patterns down onto the fabric, and now I am drawing or outlining where I'm going to cut. So Thou Art Anuli gave it like a 1/4 inch more of a seam allowance at the top of the band and the brim, and then for the full circumference of the top. But I didn't do that because this is my first project ever and I just didn't want to do that. So I'm going to pause right here just to let you guys know that I made a big mistake. Not a big mistake, but a mistake that definitely bothered me personally. So in Thou Art Anuli's video, she didn't mention about which way the fur should be laying, but you need to take that into consideration before you cut your pattern out. And I noticed, and you'll notice too later on in Thou Art Anuli's footage that I have in reference here, that her fur is cut bluntly, but she just managed to finesse it and, like, you know, shake it around and fluff it out enough where you can't tell. You could totally tell with mine, and I ended up having to go back and sew another layer onto my hat so it didn't look so bluntly cut. So if you are going to do this, just make sure that you, like, lay your fabric in a way that you don't end up chopping it off and making it super bluntly cut. Okay, back to the scheduled programming. Sorry if you hear clicking in the back, that's just my mouse. So yeah, I'm cutting this fabric out. As you can see, I'm definitely not taking into account, like, which way the fabric is going. So some of this is very bluntly cut, but that's okay. This is my first project. Yeah, I actually don't think I mentioned what you're gonna need for this project. Oh, I probably did in my intro. But if you don't know, you need fabric cutting scissors. You can get it at Hobby Lobby for like $4. Some pins, some clips, and a sewing machine. If you don't want to use a sewing machine, that's cool, but this would be a lot of work if you had to hand sew this entire thing. But if you are a whiz at hand sewing, that's good for you. You should totally do it. I need 2 of the top pieces, 4 of the brim pieces, and 4 of the band pieces. After I've cut all those pieces out, I'm going back and I'm just getting rid of all of the shed hair that it comes with this. There's so much mess that comes with working with this fabric. Leave it to me to pick the messiest fabric to work with for my first project. I'm just cleaning up right here because I'm just not the kind of person that can work in too much mess. Like, it drives me insane. So I was just cleaning up my workspace. There's still like little purple fuzzy things on my carpet still that I will have to clean. Up in the right corner is actually how it's supposed to look, like how all the pieces look if you lay it out. I just didn't lay it out for you guys, so I thought I'd go ahead and show you. But these are my pieces. They're looking nice. So now I'm pinning the 2 top pieces together, I'm clipping them together so I can get them ready to be sewn. Next is the scary part, the sewing machine. I got the sewing machine 2 Christmases ago, and I've just now decided to start using this. I have done a bunch of tutorials, so I actually know how it works, but this is my first time really getting in there with a real project. So it's just been sitting here all pretty, like, next to my plant and my tapestry of cats playing. First things first, like I said, I'm gonna sew these together. As you can see, I'm literally watching Thou Art Anuli's tutorial this entire time, making sure I'm doing it right. This part was pretty simple and pretty easy. My sewing machine understood the assignment and got her done. So now I'm sewing the band pieces, but I didn't show you guys what I was, like, what I did to get it to this point. So I'm showing you in the upper right corner. You take the 2 pieces of the band pieces, you put them together with the fur facing each other, and then you clip it all around. Or no, not the fur facing each other. You have 1 fur facing outward and 1 fur facing inward. You'll see what I mean. I also didn't show you how I did the brim. So here's also the footage from Thou Art Ali's tutorial of how you do the brim. You just sew the corners, and these are the ones where they're first facing each other. That's what I did. I sewed the 2 brim pieces together on the sides only, and then I combined that. So this took a little while because I needed to be accurate. So I'm just gonna chit chat with you guys. I know I've been gone for a super long time, and I don't really care to give an explanation. Not because I don't think you guys deserve one, but I'm just tired of excusing myself when it comes to these things, because I ended up taking time off because I needed to. It was just that simple. And just was going through a bunch of burnout, honestly. I'm a perfectionist, and it's really hard for me to put content out unless I've put 199, that's a weird number, 200% of my energy into it, and that's not sustainable. And I found that out. I did a butt ton of stuff for Halloween on TikTok, and I kind of, like, hyper focused on TikTok for a very long time because I still wasn't putting as much effort into my TikToks as I was in my YouTube videos. I was getting results quicker, and because I was getting a following a lot quicker than I would on YouTube, I kind of just was like, I'm gonna just rock with this for a little bit. And the plan was to build a following on TikTok and try to pull them over to YouTube, but that shit was whack. That was really hard to do. But I do have a TikTok following. If you want to follow me on TikTok, that would be cool. But I'm back now. No more burnout. I understand that I can't put, you know, my all and then some into every single video, or I'm just gonna be, you know, weak and destroyed and tired and on the inside. So that's why I was gone. Just taking some time to myself. I've never really claimed to be a consistent content creator. I want to be, though. That's actually part of my New Year's resolutions. I have a whole mood board that talks about it. So that's about as much explanation as I can give you as to why I've been gone. But I'm back, and I'm back, and I'm here to show you guys my life and things I like to do and things I like to talk about. I plan on talking a lot on my channel, I realize. So I hope you like my voice. You better get used to it. Okay, enough chit chat. Let's get back to what I'm doing. Okay, so once again, I forgot to show you guys how I got to this point. So I put Thou Art a Nulis tutorial in the top right corner. And here you see that she's just putting the top together along with the band, and she's clipping it all together. She made a very good point right here. She warned me and anyone else who's doing this to not try and put this through your sewing machine. And I wholeheartedly agree with where she's coming from. If you are great at hand sewing or even just decent, for the love of God, don't put this through your sewing machine. I kid you not, I broke 5 needles at this point of like the creation process because I am not confident in my hand sewing abilities. I don't even have a hand sewing needle. I did have to go out and buy more needles because I broke all of mine for the sewing machine, but nevertheless, I'm not confident in my skill of hand sewing, so I did not listen and definitely paid the price. Like, the amount of malfunctions that happened on this freaking sewing machine really tested my patience, and honestly, wow, I've come a long way. But anyway, trying to put this through the sewing machine is a lot of work. You have to be very diligent, and you, even in doing all that, you will probably still break a sewing needle or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5. You know, so just if you can hand sew it, hand sew it. If you can't, then just be prepared for this to take longer than it needs to be, because this fabric is thick and trying to fit it under the presser foot is a pain in the ass. And even if you take the presser foot off, which I did, which I don't recommend, it's still a pain in the ass. So yeah, just wanted to put that warning out there. She told you for a reason. She told me for a reason. This is not an easy thing to do. I just had no choice because I don't have any hand sewing needles. I'm too lazy to go out and get more hand sewing needles or get any of them actually. And I don't trust my ability in hand sewing quite yet. Like, I have a machine for it, so I'm gonna use it. All right, back to what's going on. Okay, so this part is the part that, once again, she definitely recommended to not put this through the sewing machine. Let me reiterate, if you can hand sew even decently, for the love of God, don't put this through your sewing machine. Not only did I break a bunch of sewing needles, but I got yarn stuck in places that it was so hard to fucking get out. Excuse my language, but God damn it, it was hard. But back to what's happening on the screen. So I didn't show you guys how I put the brim together with the now sewed band and top part. And so if you just direct your attention to the right corner again, you will see that this is how it was done. Pretty much you just clip the brim to now the top part of your hat and you hand sew it, which I did not, as you can see. I edited out a lot of the times where the sewing machine needle broke because I just honestly, I'm not a fan of showing y'all my L's, not in that way. But it did break a lot of times and my lazy ass had to get up and go out and get more like sewing needles for my machine, and still didn't get a hand sewing needle because I'm scared. But that's it. That's how I did it. Yeah, I'm gonna show you the finished product in 5, 4. Actually, you saw it in the beginning. What am I saying? Okay, forwards to Olivia, who has successfully completed the fluffy bucket hat. All right, guys, so that is how I made my beautiful, fantabulous, fantastic, fabulous bucket hat.
I know it's not perfect. I know some of these edges are a bit blunt and I got some like loose thread going on in parts of this, but I'm just so proud that I even made this to begin with. I think for my first project ever, this was actually a bit ambitious and I didn't think it was until I started doing it and realized I'm working with a very difficult fabric. Since this is my first creation ever on the sewing machine, I have deemed this my thinking hat. So anytime I have to think, I'm gonna put this hat on because it's just got all this good energy and good vibes in it. So yeah, that's enough of my weirdness for one day. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please like this video. Don't forget to subscribe. And I'm gonna catch you in the next one. The next one I'm filming today actually is gonna be me doing my birthday hair. So if you wanna see what I'm gonna be doing for my birthday hair, then go ahead and look out for that. This should be uploaded on Wednesday. So my birthday hair will be uploaded probably Saturday. So yeah. But if you don't wanna wait to see the whole video of me doing my hair, then just go follow me on Instagram or on TikTok. Both of which my username is upset_avocados. All right, y'all. Peace.